something to react to, don't we, Ollie?
Well, just then off air, we had a little...
A little conversation.
Well, we both have... Well, should we go into it
first? Yeah, right. So we're about to react to Machine Gun Kelly's return to rap. He dropped a freestyle called Renegade Freestyle. And I was unaware of this information, but producer Ollie isn't exactly Kel's biggest fan.
Is it? Oh, is you, you're on first name basis, are you? You and Kel's?
Kel's!
Oh, yeah. Me and Kel's.
Kel's. Coulson, actually, to those who know him.
The thing is, right? I liked... that first album when he went pop punk. I liked the album. Thought it was good. Thought it was catchy. It got some good songs. And then he started talking. Started opening his old little mouth, slagging off people that played Warped Tour in comfy shoes, slagging off Corey Taylor, the god of metal.
I didn't think there was anything wrong with my choice of t-shirt today. And then,
so now, and John's like John's. Whoops. Forgotten about that. It pushed it all under the rug. Oh, it's fine. I won't forget.
I'm wearing comfy shoes.
Kells. Listen, yeah? If you're watching this, I think he's on the stream.
Yeah. He loves a good live stream.
But he's going back to rap now.
He is indeed. A foray back to rap. We heard...
He's like, oh, I've milked the pop punk teat. I've drank out of the pop punk nipple for...
This is going to be such a yin and yang reaction, isn't it?
He's fucking cast Travis Barker aside now. He's like, I don't need you anymore.
Do you reckon
going back to the rap?
I don't think Travis is going to stay away from this project. There's no way. If you're making a rap record,
nah, to be fair, I said
the greatest drummer of all time.
I did see on Travis Barker's Instagram. There's a video of Blink, I think, and he was like FaceTiming Kells.
Kells, Coulson. So
they're still mates, I imagine.
That's not changing anytime soon. But
he's back.
He's back.
In the rap world.
In the rap world.
And he's calling out other rappers again.
Jack Harlow, apparently. So I haven't watched this rap. I've only seen people tweeting about it. And I just opened Twitter and I just saw people saying, MGK taking shots at Jack Harlow in new rap song. And I was like, huh, okay. And like... Okay, I'm one of the people as well who, you know how he had that whole rap battle with Eminem and everyone was like, Eminem bodied him, man. Like
the thing is, he
hit him so hard he had to switch genres. I was like, listen to Rap Devil and tell me.
Do you know what? The thing is, like, Rap Devil was great, but I feel like Eminem probably came on top in that battle. But at the end of the day, they're both winners because they both... have millions of views on those videos.
Yeah, they
do. They're laughing all the way to the bloody bank.
Yeah, they are.
Sounded really northern then.
To the bloody bank.
Laughing to the bloody bank.
Laughing to the bank.
Yeah. Should we check out the new rap freestyle?
Absolutely. We've got subtitles on as well, just so we can make sure we're picking up word for word what he's saying.
All the effing and jeffing.
Yeah.
Wait, should we do a quick backyard check?
What's going on in the backyard?
Nice,
I tell you what.
Barbecue.
Tell you what, nice little bit of weight on that.
I don't know if you know, but John works out.
I've been known to pick stuff up and put it down again.
Yeah, he can't wear t-shirts anymore.
I know, it's serious, my friends. I am actually allergic to sleeves.
Yeah. This is the only show, rain or shine, rain, whatever the weather, John will always be wearing
it. Oh, yeah. If you've ever seen me at a festival or a gig, do you ever notice the fact that I've never got anything to sleeves?
If you got arms like that, would you hide them away? No. And MGK's been working out. Look at all this.
Yeah. Nice little pull-up bar in the back as well. Like, I think that could potentially
That's his house.
A squat rack.
I don't think that's his house because it looks a bit too, like, common. You'd imagine he's got a bit of cash.
Don't judge a book by its cover. You never know. Like some
I'm not people, slagging off. I'm just some, saying if you're a like multi-millionaire.
Might like a little minimalist lifestyle. Yeah. Although you can't say that when he was walking around on his birthday with a fucking flamethrower.
Exactly. Right, let's check out Renegade Freestyle.
Renegade!
All right, we're live in the homie's backyard.
Homie's backyard.
It's just me and the
Cypher. It's not his.
Kel's put his own subtitles on.
Yeah.
we need to pull them up.
Can you turn me up?
Yo. Hey, yo. Sit back and watch me do this. Correct all the stupids who tried to put me in the box I had to solve like Rubik's. With no blueprints, just music. Nothing they say about me on computers compares to a dad who was abusive. I go to war with these stars, no George Lucas. Make a call and here's Johnny. Keep me shining like I'm Stanley Kubrick. That line went over your head like the Airbender's tattoo is. Next line that goes into my nose might make me overdo it.
Okay.
I spend so much of my personal savings on Colombian pure cocaine. I should speak Spanish like I'm Cali Uchis. So fucking sick I could piss mucus.
So fucking sick I could piss mucus.
What a fucking bar.
The thing is, right, I'm no expert at rap, but sometimes I feel like people just say stuff that sounds clever. When you actually think about it, it's not actually clever. They put words together that are related and they're like, this is like this and like this, but then when you think about it, it's like, well, it's not really. You just pick two things which have a sort of...
Have you seen the new Guardians of the Galaxy?
I'm at war with the stars, like not like George Lucas or something. What does that even mean?
That
it sounds clever.
It's, one second.
Listen, I've got a big brain over here.
One second, let's go back to that. Where's the Lucas line? Correct all the stupids who tried to put me in the box.
I had to solve like Rubik's with no... I had to solve like Rubik's. See, sounds clever, right? Think about it. What does it mean?
A Rubik's
cube. They tried to put him in a box.
Yeah, like
that he had to solve, like Rubik's.
So he had to get out of it.
Had to get out of it. Oh, yeah. It kind of works. It's just music. Let you off. Nothing they say about me on computers compares to a dad
who was abusive. I go to war with these stars. So I go to war with these stars. No, no George Lucas.
I'm street, no Corey. My favorite. Do you know when I used to watch a little bit of UK rap battle? One of the guys.
Don't flop it.
Yeah. One of my favorite lines is, I'm street, no Corey. Anytime someone does like a something, no, I always think of that.
I think it's Luna C from Don't Flop It. It came out with the bar, where I'm from, Philadelphia is just a spreadable cheese.
Yeah.
Oh, what a fucking bar. But I tell you what, Kells does love his movie rap references. Because there's a lyric in a song that he features on. I want to say it's on Trippie Redd's album Pegasus. And there's a bar where he says something like Eternal Sunshine of a Spotless Mind. And to get that film title into a line is fucking hard with that many syllables.
Yeah. What's he rhyme it with?
I don't ask me that. Johnny, keep shining like I'm Stanley Kubrick. That line went over your head like the Airbender's tattoo is. Next line that goes into my nose might make me overdo it. I spent so much of my personal savings.
Colombian pure cocaine.
Lot of drug I should
speak Spanish like I'm Cali Uchis. So fucking sick I could piss mucus. I'm the shit when I sit, stand, talk, walk, rap, sing. My mouth sewage. Holy shit, someone chew this. The truth is my closest tried to cross me like Judas, but can't cross me like I'm Jewish. That crosshair's a little shaky. They miss me by 2 inch. I'm cross-legged in my sanctuary like a Buddhist. I'm cross-eyed from this weed I'm smoking that's colored bluish. This gun is my son. I'm the father of Draco like Lucius.
Ugh, make that sure Harry Potter no confusions.
I'm a great white. I can eat these barracudas. See who I am? You're stupid. It's nice to meet you. I just put this hole in the ground for you like a soccer cliche. I see why they...
Go on.
Don't think great white sharks eat barracudas. And can we just... I don't want that. I think this is quite good, to be fair. But listen, yeah.
I don't think it...
I used to play football, as we call it over here. What the fuck is a soccer cleat shoe? Is that a football boot?
Americans call... Yeah, they call it... They call cleats. It a cleat.
Soccer cleat shoe.
They're just called...
Hey, cleats. Pass me my soccer cleat shoe. Mom, gotta go play soccer... Soccer cleat shoe. Jesus Christ.
I don't think
he's I'm not slagging it all off. It is he's got some good bars. Good flow. Imagine you're watching this as like a serious like if you're a serious like rapper and I'm just like I know nothing. I have no credentials for this sort of music.
When it comes to analyzing rap, I will say that like other than like choice of words or rhyming patterns, like we don't have much.
I'm when it's a good line, I'm like, yeah, oh yeah. But I don't know. I think I'm too picky to be like, well, what does that mean?
Yeah. No, I get you.
But I guess probably a lot of songs I listen to in the rock world probably have shit lyrics, don't they? They're all shit, aren't they?
Dude, like some of my favorite shit lyrics.
I mean, I grew up listening to Limp Bizkit.
Yeah. Like stupid lyrics are one of my favorite things to find within songs.
Hey kid, take my advice. Don't want to step into a big pile of shit.
The water's Titanic.
Yep. So that's the sort of level I'm at.
We've still got a minute for Kels to impress you.
Let's get it back on. But you like a soccer cliche. I see why they call
you Jack Man. You Jack Man's whole swag. Give Drake his flow back, man. So that was the shot at Jack Harlow. Like must I regurgitate and show you who's in my stomach from the last dance? I battle rap. No Instagrams are yelling at the cam. Damn, y'all may be the villain when all along I've been Batman. I off-road in this Can-Am. Desert sand on this shirt from Barney's and I'm stoned like Bam Bam. Eyes red like Cardi. I'm a nice. Curse like Goddamn. I'm a nightmare reference. Like Freddy in your dreams like the Sandman. Don't go to sleep.
You won't wake up from that. There's a lot of references, isn't there?
Little Metallica reference for you.
Wait, what? I missed it.
So
oh, Enter Sandman. What was it?
There we go.
I'm a nightmare like Freddy in your dreams like the Sandman. Yeah. Enter night.
Yeah.
You know the words. Man, don't go to sleep. You won't wake up from that. Fetal position in front of me at my feet like a welcome mat. I hold these grudges, I don't welcome back. Fuck subliminal nudges, I throw these punches and I rap. I love you, look at all you little Dylan Brooks. I don't give a fuck if I'm older, I'm colder. You poked the bear in the woods, came back like LeBron and dropped 40 on you like I should. The only thing I ever wished is that y'all fucking would. Cool.
Not bad for a little minute and a half freestyle from Kels.
To be fair, I feel like the point of freestyles isn't meant to be like, you wouldn't write it like you would a proper song, would you? It's like...
just all references, like what shots can you take? Like what lyrical flow can you demonstrate?
Yeah, and it's just like, it's his way of being like, I'm back.
Yeah.
Jack.
And taking shots at Jack Harlow as well. What do you think of that, my friends? Let us know your thoughts on the brand new Machine Gun Kelly freestyle.
What's Jack gonna say back, eh? Is he gonna make a track?
Is Jack,
you know what, as like petty as it sort of seems, I do like a good bit of beef.
Yeah, like
there's not enough in like the rock and metal world.
No, like, right, I was saying this when Eminem and MGK had their whole feud, is that like a lot of people are theorizing that it was like constructed behind the scenes and both were in on it and like that kind of thing. Even if they were, people got invested in it. And like, if you look at the inspiration that happened off the back of that, all of a sudden, do you remember the YouTubers, like the Sidemen and all those people?
Yeah.
They all started doing rap battles against each other. So like, it literally...
if it gets views, then people will do it. We might have to have a fucking diss.
Oh, should we have a rap battle? Should we fall out and have a rap battle and it's all fake?
We'll still do the show, but I'll drop a diss track.
I'll Ollie on you like I'm Tony Hawk.
See, again, what does that even mean? You're me on you. What was that?
You're me on you. Oh, God. Lamb says, please have a rap battle.
Give me a beat.
Give me a week and give me a beat.
I'm not doing it live. I reckon on a track.
You could tape me.
If I wrote
if it was pre-prepared.
Yeah. I don't think I could do a freestyle.
Give me and Ollie a week, we'll come back.
I could write you a metal track.
Oh yeah, if you asked Ollie to ad lib you something like a riff or a breakdown, like you cook.
I don't know if you've heard the intro for the show. If you like that music. That's one of mine.
I keep meaning to ask you, did you write that? Yeah. Let's fucking... my friends, could we give one of those to producer Ollie, please?
That's one of mine.
With just how fucking talented he is making all of this.
Because I don't want to pay anyone else for music. Royalty free, baby.
Royalty free.